greed, wrath, envy, lust, sloth, pride, and gluttony are the seven sins that corrupt a man's heart. Having just one will form into darkness. Greed is what a wealthy man clings to. Wrath is a man of war. Envy is what women want to be. Lust is to take another's humanity. Sloth is watching others succeed. Pride is never your fault. Gluttony is the pigs who eat what the poor do not have. The darkness builds and torments the soul of a man. The church speaks of these sins. The darkness is everywhere and manifests in everyone. Repent your sins and you will be saved, for God forgives all. Sin's favorite words from man, whispering those words into the ear, letting them know God will save them. Sleep with thy neighbor and relieve your lustful thoughts. Keep eating and you will never go hungry. Keep your money and belongings so they are not touched by dirty hands. Beat your wife when she disobeys you. Rest your head and sleep so the world will never harm you. Kill the one that is better than you. Look down upon the poor, for they do not earn your respect. God will forgive you, my children. Never let sin taint your heart, and you will be welcomed into heaven's gates. The king's heart was one of the purest, and sin did not taint him. As the king grew older, he wished to have a child whose heart was purer than his, to rule the kingdom and to lead his people to the light and away from sin. After a year, his beloved wife gave birth to a babe whose hair was the color of fall. The king and queen named her Autumn, and she was the purest the church and kingdom had ever laid eyes on. Theodore the bishop envied the king and his wife for their daughter's beauty. Theodore lusted to have the king's daughter as his wife. As Autumn grew, her beauty followed. Kings from lands far away begged Luther for their daughter's hand to wed their sons. The king refused every proposal and gave his daughter the power to marry whomever she found as pure as her. My lord, your daughter growing into a beautiful young lady. Arturo explained to his king. Arturo was the king's right-hand man. Yes, she is, my friend Arturo, hugging his friend, the king said proudly. When did you arrive from your homeland? He asked. I just arrived this morning, senor. I also brought mi hijo, Patricio, Arturo said, putting his hand on the boy's head. The boy walked to the king and bowed his head. Gracias, my lord, for having me to your castillo, the boy said in a joyful tone. The king laughed and hugged the boy. Mi casa es tu casa, my lord. Arturo was from Spain and was visiting his wife and children. Arturo was away from the kingdom for a couple of years and returned when his wife passed from an unknown sickness. I am terribly sorry for your loss. How are your other children? Luther asked Arturo. Mis hijos are fine. They are staying with mi madre y padre. I brought Patricio with me to train him and to meet a new friend. Arturo patted Patricio's head and gently pushed him to introduce himself to the princess, who was in the courtyard tending to the garden of the king. Cuidado, hijo. I heard she is a rose with thorns, Arturo teased his son. Her name is Autumn, and I hope you will become friends and guardian as you grow older, said Luther, smiling at the boy. Patricio smiled at the king and his father and walked to the princess. Hola, princesa, my name is Patricio, and I will... He bowed his head, and when she turned to him while he spoke, he paused in astonishment and was stunned by her beauty. You will what? She said in a harsh voice. Lo siento, I will be your protector and amigo. Why do I need a protector if I have my father's guards to watch after me? The queen looked at her daughter with a scowl. Hush, my child, and be calm. This is Arturo's son, and he will be staying with us. Patricio smiled from ear to ear. See, I will be staying with you, and we'll make sure nothing happens to you, princess. As time went on, they played together every day and took care of each other. They played with the children, playing tag, hide-and-seek, acting, and so much more. When the princess was bullied, Patricio would always fight with them and defended his princesa. As the years went by, they were inseparable, and Autumn's heart grew to love Patricio, and Patricio loved hers. When Patricio and Autumn became young adults, Arturo explained to the king he was homesick and missing his other children. Patricio did not argue with his father, but his heart grew heavy with the thought of leaving his princesa. Arturo and Patricio left the kingdom with the king's blessings. I will write to you every day, princesa, and I will come back your caballero de brillante armadura, Patricio screamed so the world could hear.